In historic terms, malaria is perhaps the most important disease that mankind has ever known. It's been estimated that every second person that ever has lived on the planet died as a result of malaria. That is 52 billion people overall. The ones that die are mostly children below the age of 5 and pregnant women. So it is still with us and it is still a very important disease. Literally thousands and thousands of mosquitoes breeding here in these rice paddies, and people, the villages are right around it. So that means that the mosquitoes that come out of these rice paddies, they will fly to these villages, they will bite people, and as a result of that, we will have a lot of transmission of the disease. We will be working in these rice paddies, and controlling mosquitoes here over this large area is obviously very difficult, and that's why we're seeking solutions through which we can do this better and can do this faster.
By helicopter, this work in Africa cannot be done. Just too expensive. By hand, too time consuming. What could fill the gap between a helicopter and hand spraying?
3 years ago, a small organization called Anti-Malaria Drones came to us with a fantastic idea, fighting malaria in a more efficient way by using drones. For that purpose, we had to customize one of our off-the-shelf platforms called Agras MG-1S. We had to integrate new mechanical pumps able to spray a biodegradable agent.
The point is that by doing that, we have a very small little film that is on the surface of the water, which prevents the larvae of the mosquito from breathing. So they suffocate and they die. It's a very simple approach. So by just flying over all these paddies, spraying this biological control agent, we are hoping to really reduce the number of mosquitoes that come out of these rice fields and go out and bite these people. In this case, it's actually a chemical that has been used for covering drinking water basins. So it's actually completely safe for humans. It's completely safe for other organisms in the ecosystem. The drones can work fast. We can take 10 liters of fluid up in the air these days. It's fairly easy to train people to use the drones and actually fly them. It is beyond any doubt that if you get rid of malaria altogether, it will have an enormous socio-economic impact. Very simple. We get a healthy farmer, that means we get a good crop yield, that means there's more income for the family, that means there's more education for the children, and everybody will benefit from it. You're going to have an impact on all other elements of society. It's costing the continent of Africa more than $12 billion per year just to have people being treated with drugs, taken care of, etc., etc. If we integrate the technologies that we have today, the nets, the spraying, the drugs, the diagnostics, everything that we have today, but we add on the new tools, for instance, the drones, that we may actually achieve going down to zero and keeping it there. And that's really important.
So the first part of the project has just been finalized. Now it's all about the local community here to continue with the data gathering processes. Once we have it all, the last part of the project starts, when we will analyze all that data and we will scale up this project to all affected regions where this type of technology can make a difference.
We treated this field yesterday and I'm really happy to see there are no new mosquitoes in it today.
People have been suffering malaria for thousands of years. In fact, we've been fighting malaria for decades. And now we have this type of technology, we have the drone technology to win this battle against malaria once and for all.